Space. The final frontier. These are the voyages of a new Trekkie. My 5-year mission to search out Star Trek media, to seek out other fans and merchandise, to boldly go where no fan has gone before.
It's been a while since we've looked at the world of Star Trek Enterprise, in this case looking at 3 episodes. In this case, Doctor's Orders, The Hatchery, the episode Azati Prime. Let's look at Doctor's Orders first. What actually happened in this episode? Well, in this episode, Dr. Phlox and Commander T'Pol guide the ship through an area of dangerous space while the rest of the crew are comatose. And ever so often, Phlox ends up seeing, like, you know, very strange things that are going on. Honestly, I gotta say, I like the vibes that this episode was giving off. Like, say, almost like, say, spooky vibes. In that, like, say, and since the fact that everyone is asleep, and, like, you know, we have every moments of, like, say, Dr. Phlox suddenly seeing insectoids, and he's just going to say, "I will get them!" And, you know, getting his guns like he just saw a giant cockroach or something like that. And, yeah, I do like the fact that he is the doctor's going to do that. And yes, like whenever we see these moments that are kind of freaky, whether it is also a zombie version of Hoshi, I gotta say those moments are pretty great. The makeups, the effects of them are honestly really good. And honestly, I think this is pretty good idea for, like, you know, like an idea for an episode in which, like say, is a person gone insane? Is he hallucinating and all that? And, you know, it's like, say, whenever it comes to Trek, it's always pretty cool to have an episode that has more of, like a spooky invaders hallucination kind of vibes. And I do kind of like, I think the twist of it is that, you know, like, say, oh, so, T'Pol was, she was kind of asleep. That the entire time T'Pol was kind of asleep as well, so we have that going for it. So it's just kind of, you know, like, until the end of it, we don't realize, oh, hey, so this is actually what's going on. And, I mean, overall, I thought this episode was pretty entertaining. Let's look at next episode. And in this episode, The Hatchery, what actually happened in this? Well, Captain Jonathan Archer discovers an insectoid egg hatchery on a downed Xindi ship and becomes obsessed with protecting the eggs. And in a way, the rest of the crew feels like, say, has Captain gone a bit kooky? And both Tarker and T'Pol, they all try to say, hey, Captain, you gotta wake up. Honestly, like, say, the moments where, like, say, the moments when Archer is, say, hey, like, when he's talking about, like, say, how his grandfather was and all that, how, hey, they tried to protect schools and all that as an allegory for his perspective and thinking. I think it, honestly, like, say, yes, we at some point we kind of understand, like, say, hey, he's, like, you know, he's, like, in his mind, even though he's been kind of, been sprayed with a kind of, hormone kind of thing that will, you know, make him become protective of the alien hatched and all that. I don't know. I mean, I thought the, like, yes, the captain is, like, you know, kind of hurting the mission. But at the same time, like, you can kind of understand how, like, say, if, you know, you saw something that was truly sad, how you would want to really help those individuals. And I do have to say, the set design for it, I think even, Scott Bakula, I think he did a great job in this episode.
If it'll make the two of you feel better, I'll go to sick bay for a complete physical. As soon as that reactor's online.
That's not good enough, sir. Phlox has the authority to order you to sick bay.
T'Pol's manipulating you, isn't she? If I'm declared unfit for duty, then she takes over.
Captain, if you won't come with me, I'll be required under Starfleet Order 104, Section C, to relieve you of command.
I expected something like this from her. But not from the two of you.
I mean, honestly, I kind of liked it. And, like, say, the storyline between Reed and... the storylines between Reed and Major Hayes, like, I kind of like the fact that that storyline between the them continued instead of just, like, said, okay, we've had the this between them, now we're gonna move on. Now, I kind of like the fact that, you know, hopefully they're, like, you know, like, not rivalry, but they're, I don't know what you would call it, like, saying, you know, their issues with each other, you know, kind of continues, because it's intriguing us, like, it's intriguing to see two different perspectives, like, say, you know, a military perspective, and then more of a, like, a, not a soldier's perspective, I guess. But overall, I thought it was pretty good. So what happened in the Azati Prime? Well, in this episode, the crew tracks a Xindi super weapon down to a planet, and Captain Archer seeks to destroy the weapon in a suicide attack. He is captured, and the Enterprise is seriously damaged after an attack by four Xindi vessels. I think this episode was pretty good. The thing that makes it feel a bit different is in the fact it almost feels like a season finale, but it's not. So, yeah, like, you know, it almost feels like, say, it, you know how, like, most episodes of Trek, like, there would always be episodes that were, like, a two-parter, like, where, like, say, okay, this is, like, the beginning, the end of the season, and here's the next season. I think it, seems pretty good if I, like, say, okay, it gets really intrigued, okay, what's gonna happen next? And I do think the moments when, like, Archer is being held hostage by the Xindi, and he is just, you know, like, not taking them seriously. He's talking, like, say, hey, on my planet, we had dinosaurs, and then... and they... went extinct. And, yeah, they're just like, say, wait, what are you talking about? Kind of vibes. I do think that the moments when, like, whether it was Tucker or the captain, whenever they went onto the planet in the underwater sequences, I thought that was pretty cool. I finally say the idea of a starship going underwater, like a submarine or something like that, but going down there quicker, was pretty cool.
Oh, don't mind that. It's just the cat.
And, yeah, I mean, I also think it's pretty cool, though, is at the end of it, with a the race of Xindi that aren't the, not insectoids, but the, not the reptilianist looking ones, they discover, they realize, like, say, hey, they have been kind of, the weapon that they're trying to build is kind of only helping the, not insectoid, but the reptilian looking ones. I don't remember the name of them, I'm sorry. Because there's insectoid ones, there's the ones that are in a fish tank, and all of that. Yeah, at a certain point it goes like, say, what in the heck? Because it's hard to like, yeah, so they all are saying like, where is Xindi and all that. Because there's like, say, there's different versions of Xindi. And I do have to say that one thing that was pretty cool was we get the return of the character of Daniels, who was a part of the crew.
Quiet. Quiet. Quit stomping around. Scat! Oh, my nerves.
Crew, except he comes from the future, so he's able to tell, like, say, hey, Archer, this is what's up in the future. And it still makes me think, okay, there's something big that's going to happen in as the series goes on, and that the Xindi, I don't think they ever show up again. Because, like, yeah, like, say, it would have made sense that they, I mean, then again, yeah, when it would have had been a total rewrite for them to have appeared in some, like, new worlds, or something like that, they would have had to appear in the newer shows, but honestly, I gotta say, it was pretty good. I'm actually pretty interested in how the episode ended. I want to see the next episode of this. Alright. See you next time.